Hello everyone, in this video let's have a look at the Crdroid ROM for the Poco X3 Pro, and let me tell you why this is one of the best ROM for the Poco X3 Pro.
So as you can see here, it is based out of Android version 12 and this is the version 8.7 of the Crdroid ROM, and it also has the latest standard security patch level as of now. Here's the wildlife score that I got with this particular ROM, and here you can have a look at the DRM info, and as you can see here the security level is L1, and this is the stock launcher that this ROM comes with. And as you can see here, there are certain options here like icon pack can be changed, notification dots, and icon size, font size, max lines per label. You can also customize the home screen, and here are the app drawer customizations, and this is the recent style that can be changed into the grid format as you can see here. And you can have the option of clear all lens if you want, but I disable that. And here are the miscellaneous options as you can see here. And you also have the option for hidden and protected apps. You have the wallpaper in style section, and this is the usual options. You can change up the basic colors, you can change to light theme or dark theme if you want, and you can also enable themed icons, change the app grid size to your liking. There are a lot of options here, and as you can see here the app grid has changed. And this is the camera app. This is the default one that comes inbuilt into this ROM, and this is quite identical to the MIUI camera app that you see, and it has all the features. So that is really awesome that you get this inbuilt fully featured MIUI camera app with this ROM. And as you can see here, there's the option of 90 FPS in BGMI/PUBG on this particular ROM, which can be enabled. I'll show you those settings later. And here are the custom Crdroid settings that come with this particular ROM. Let me quickly go through them. You can have a look at them and pause the video in case you miss out on something. I'll just quickly go through those settings as you can see here. And let me talk about the day-to-day performance and other stuff about this particular ROM. So overall, this ROM has been really stable for me. I haven't faced any major bugs or any random reboots or any lags or stutters so far this particular ROM, or have it behave any way that it shouldn't. And battery life has been pretty rock solid for me as well. I'm able to get about 7 plus hours of screen on time, which is pretty great for my particular heavy usage. And as you can see here, this ROM is filled with features that you would want from a particular ROM. As you can see here, there are tons of options, and I have explained all these options in my previous Crdroid video. So if you want a more explanatory view of this features, you can have a look at those. And as you can see here, there are the Monet settings. As you can see here, you can change up the color shade if you want, you can change the navbar style. You have certain font options which can be easily switched from here. You can change the icon pack, signal style, Wi-Fi style, icon shape can also be changed from here. You have certain notification options like reticule, blink, flashlight for incoming call. You have sound options. As you can see here, you can enable the pulse, you can change the volume steps for more granular control, you can change the volume panel position. As you can see here, now it appears on the left. And here are certain in-call vibration options. You have some miscellaneous settings like the game space, and you can disable certain stuff to have carefree gaming experience. And as you can see here, from here you can unlock the higher FPS in games, and this is what I did earlier. And you also have the unlimited Google Photos storage, and there are certain other options hidden away under the display section. As you can see here, you can make your display extra dim if you want. You have lock screen options, and do note that there is a face unlock option present on this ROM, and it works great. I have no issues with it. You have night light, live display options as you can see here. And you can also adjust the minimum and the maximum refresh rate if you want. So that's it for this video. If you liked it, click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Bye bye. Take care.